फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू ऑटोमेशन 2050 चैनल। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी अबाउट डिसीजन ट्री। सो इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू गिव यू फोर सिंपल वेज टू स्प्लिट योर डिसीजन ट्री इन मशीन लर्निंग। सो इन सिनॉप्सिस अबाउट टुडेज वीडियो, हाउ डू यू स्प्लिट योर डिसीजन ट्री, व्हाट आर ऑल द डिफरेंट स्प्लिटिंग क्राइटेरिया व्हेन वर्किंग विद डिसीजन ट्रीज, एंड ऑल्सो डिसीजन ट्री स्प्लिटिंग मेथड्स एंड पॉपुलर ML algorithms। सो I will tell you what is decision tree used for. Decision trees arrange information in a tree-like structure, classifying information along various branches. So, for example, each branch represent alternative route a question. That is, each structure can be used to help you to predict likely values of data attribute. So decision trees, or otherwise called as DT, it's a predictive model expressed as a recursive partition of the feature space to subspaces that constitute a basis for prediction. A DT is a rooted directed tree. So that means the nodes with outgoing edges are the internal nodes. All the other nodes are terminal nodes or leaves of the DT. DT is classified using a set of hierarchical decisions on the features. The decisions made at internal nodes are the split criterion. In DTs, each leaf is like assigned to one class or its probability. Thus, the error contribution due to variance is large for DT. So, if you don't know about the error contribution, I will give you the link below. In DT, learning is a supervised machine learning technique for indexing a decision tree from training data. It's also a classification tree. Or a reduction tree is a predictive model which is a mapping from observations about an item to conclusions about its target value. Building a decision tree that is consistent with a given data set is easy. The challenge lies in building good decision trees, which is typically means the smallest decision trees. So coming to the point, decision tree is a flowchart-like structure in which each internal node represents a text on an attribute, for example, whether a coin flips, comes up head or tail. Each branch represents the outcome of the test, and each leaf node represents a class labeled decision taken after computing all attributes. The path from root to leaf represents a classification rule. In decision analysis, a decision tree and a closely related influence diagram are used as a ritual and analytical decision support tool, where the expected value, that is the expected utility of computing alternatives, are calculated. I will give you the three types of nodes: decision nodes, that is represented in square form; chances nodes, that is represented in circle form; and nodes, which are representing in triangle form. Decision tree elements are drawn from left to right. A decision tree has only burst nodes, splitting paths, but no sink nodes, converging paths. Therefore, used manually, they can grow very big and are often hard to draw fully by hand. Decision trees are simple to implement and easy to interrupt too. So let's quickly revise: parent and child node, root node, leaf node. These are all the three important nodes. So parent or child node. So coming from root node, there will be two parent nodes, and each parent node has child nodes. So totally two parents, four child nodes, and all these four childs are represented as leaf nodes. A parent and child node, a node that gets divided into like subnodes is known as parent node, and these subnodes are known as child node. Since a node can be divided into multiple subnodes, therefore a node can act as a parent node of numerous child nodes. Root node, the topmost node of the decision tree, is root node. It doesn't have any parent node. It represents the entire population. Leaf node, it doesn't have any child node, or known as terminal or leaf node. What is node splitting? Before learning going to the decision tree, I believe it is essential to understand why we are learning it. So, Since you all know how extensively decision trees are used, there is no denying the fact that learning about decision trees is a must. Because it makes decision by splitting nodes into subnodes. This process is performed multiple times during the training process until only homogeneous nodes are left. And this is why the reason why a decision tree can perform so well. Therefore, node splitting is a key concept that everyone should know. Node splitting or simply splitting is the process of dividing a node into multiple subnodes to create relatively pure nodes. So, for example, there are multiple ways of doing it because it can be broadly classified into two categories, that is based upon the type of target variable. One is continuous target variable, second one is categorical target variable. Continuous target variable will come under reduction in variance, whereas categorical target variable will come under information gains, chi-square, Gini impurity. I will start with DT splitting method. First one is reduction in variance. What is reduction in variance? Reduction in variance is the method for splitting the node used when the target variable is continuous. That is the regression problems. It's so called because it uses variance as a measure for deciding the feature on which the node is split into child nodes. For example, variance is equal to sigma of x minus mu the whole square division by n. As you all know, the variance formula used for calculating the homogeneity of the node. If the node is entirely homogeneous, what the decision, the variance is zero. So what are the steps? There are some steps to split a decision tree using reduction and variance. For example, first one, for each split, I individually calculate the variance of each child node. Second one, calculate the variance of each split as a weighted average variance of child nodes. Third one, select the split with the lowest variance. Fourth one, perform steps 1 to 3 until completely homogeneous nodes are achieved. So, in order to, there are 4 steps. Step 1, like for the reduction in variance, that is the first DT splitting method. Step 1 is for each split, individually calculate the variance of each child node. Second one is calculate the variance of each split as the weighted average variance of child nodes. Third one is select the split with the lowest variance. Fourth one is perform 1 to 3 steps. Second DT splitting method, step 2, like the method 2, information gain. Now, what if we have a categorical target variable? Well, the answer is information gain is used for splitting the nodes when the target variable is categorical. Information gain is equal to 1 minus entropy, while entropy is used for calculating the purity of the node. Lower the value of entropy, higher the purity of the node, like that. So the entropy of the homogeneous node is 0. Since we subtract entropy from 1, the information gain is higher for the purer nodes with a maximum value of 1. So entropy is equal to minus sigma I is equal to 1 to n pi log 2 pi. These formulas are there in, if you are going to Google it, entropy, it will come. These formula are the basic formula which we already studied during the basics of ML. So, steps for, there is each and every steps for each and, as I told you earlier, reduction for variance. There are also some steps for information gain. Step 1, for each split, individually calculate the entropy of each child node. Step 2, calculate the entropy of each split as the weighted average entropy of child nodes. Step 3, select the split with the lowest entropy or highest IG, that is information gain. Fourth step, you have to achieve, repeat the step 1 to 3 till it achieves the homogeneous nodes. For each and every step, I will, if I am going to tell this step, you have to visually see also. So I will give you the reference video, YouTube video in the, below in the description box. Step 3 is a DT splitting method, Gini impurity. So Gini impurity is the method for splitting the nodes when the target variable is categorical. So it's mostly Gini impurity is equal to 1 minus Gini. What is Gini? Gini is the probability of correctly labeling a randomly chosen element if it was randomly labeled according to the distribution of labels in the node. So sigma minus I is equal to 1 to n pi square. So Gini impurity is 1 minus sigma I is equal to 1 to n pi square. Lower the Gini impurity, higher the homogeneity of the node. The Gini impurity of the pure node is 0. So Gini impurity is preferred to information gain because it doesn't have any contains some logarithms which are computatively intensive. So there are some steps for Gini too. Step 1, similar to what we did in information gain, for each split individually calculate the Gini impurity. of each child node. Second step, calculate the Gini impurity of each split as the weighted average Gini impurity of child nodes. Step 3, select the split with the lowest value of Gini impurity. Step 4, until you achieve homogeneous nodes, repeat step 1 to step 3. Step 4 is chi square. Decision tree splitting method. TT splitting method, chi square. Chi square is the another method of splitting nodes in a decision tree for datasets having categorical target variables. It can make two or more than two splits. It works on statistical significance of difference between the parent and child nodes. Square root of actual minus expected, the whole square division by expected. Here the expected is the expected value for the class in the child node based on the distribution of classes in the parent node, and actual is the actual value for the classes in the child node. Chi square is equal to square root of actual minus expected, the whole square division by the expected. Many people know about chi square before these two. So, steps to split a decision tree using chi square. For each step, step 1. For each step, individually calculate the chi square value of each child node by taking the sum of chi square values for each class in a node. Step 2 is calculate the chi square value of each split as the sum of chi square values for all the child nodes. Step 3 is to select the split with higher chi square value. Step 4 is to, until you achieve homogeneous nodes, repeat step 1 to step 3. So, in this video, we have I gave you a very 1 minute introduction about DT. There are lots to do about DT. So I gave you the 1 minute introduction to DT, and I have explained you 4 important steps of DT methods. That is reduction in variance, that is continuous target variable, and Gini impurity, information gain, chi square, which it come under categorical target variable. So hope this video is useful for you. Please like, share and subscribe to Automation 2050 channel for further videos. So, as I told you yesterday, I have to publish part 2 for Kaggle and part 2 for Decision Tree in the next upcoming weeks. In the next upcoming weeks, I will publish part 2 Kaggle, part 2 Decision Tree with hands-on experience for you all. Thank you. Keep subscribing and stay tuned. Subscribe and share our Automation 2050 channel to all your friends and families. Thank you so much. Stay home, stay safe.